Hi there, thanks for watching today. In this video, you will learn about the governance challenge of climate migration in urban deltas. Climate migration refers to the migration of people affected by climate change impacts such as sea level rise, extreme weather events, drought, or water scarcity. These impacts can severely damage villages or cities and may force people to migrate. This is a governance challenge that is still lacking effective responses, however. There have been many warnings about climate migration. It is feared that climate change will cause mass migration flows across continents, but thus far there's no solid evidence for such extreme warnings to be correct. For example, estimates about the number of climate migrants have been criticized for being mere guesswork. They tend to simplify reality. They, for instance, ignore adaptation strategies taken to prevent migration. They ignore that people may not move but actually choose to stay behind or have no resources to move. There's also no evidence for mass climate migration flows across continents. Instead, most climate migrants remain within their home country. And also, it's rare that climate change acts as the sole and primary driver of migration. Nonetheless, it's acknowledged that climate change functions as an additional push factor of migration. And the climate change impacts on communities will increase as global warming becomes more severe, so it is an issue that we need to take seriously. Cities are primary destinations for climate migrants. Migrants from vulnerable rural areas move to urban centers as cities offer opportunities for an alternative livelihood. Climate migration therefore adds to the complexity of current processes of urbanization. But climate change will also affect cities. So people are not necessarily safe there either once they migrate to cities. Cities are often strategically located close to the sea or river deltas, so this makes cities vulnerable to sea level rise and extreme weather events. Cities from both the global north and the global south are at risk, including cities like Dhaka, Mumbai, New York, New Orleans, Amsterdam, and many more. Urban dwellers may respond in various ways to climate impacts. One is a rapid outward migration, and the other scenario is that people become trapped in a city and have no means to move away in time. The poor and marginalized groups are at higher risk to stay behind, as they have less resources and powerful social networks to rely on. These marginalized groups will largely be from informal settlements like slums, and those that are particularly prone to climate risks such as flooding. But those with more resources and better networks have better chances to leave the city when a disaster hits. But without proper policies and evacuation plans, also such outward migration can become chaotic and add to the distress. These two response scenarios were, for instance, clearly visible when Hurricane Katrina hit New Orleans in 2005. The middle class was largely able to flee New Orleans in advance due to higher levels of network capital. They owned a car. They had contacts outside the city, but the poor were left behind, as they, for instance, did not own a car and there was no well-functioning public transport. The US government was also not well prepared to assist those who were left behind. Systems of provisioning collapsed of, for instance, food, energy, water, medical supplies, which added to the vulnerability of the urban poor. Whilst the risks for local communities are growing, there's still a lack of effective governance strategies that protect climate migrants, including those who are forced to stay behind. Most attention goes to the development of global or national protection frameworks for climate migrants, but coherent policies and governance strategies on the urban level are still in a very early stage. To further promote urban governance responses to the problem of climate migration, a good starting point is for cities to discuss this topic in transnational city networks. These networks facilitate learning and best practice exchange. Such discussions should not focus only on better infrastructural strategies to protect densely populated areas, but also aim to ensure a more coordinated disaster response and inclusive policies that protect the urban poor and marginalized groups. A city network that may offer such a response is the Asian Cities Climate Change Resilience Network. One of its objectives is to promote a more holistic approach to adaptation. It does so by moving away from endorsing only technical and infrastructural adaptation planning to also promoting better policies that address the social consequences of climate change for urban deltas, such as policies to manage increased migration flows or to protect marginalized groups that are not able to flee a climate disaster in time. In sum, climate migration is an emerging issue for urban governance. But still much needs to be done to better protect climate migrants, including those who are left behind. Do you think climate migrants should be better protected?